This podcast has been sponsored by the Gottlieb family in Marion Station, Pennsylvania, in honor of their grandmothers who have lived Jewish values and shared their wisdom with the next generation.
This is The Book of Life, a podcast that uncovers life lessons from Judaism's most important book, helping you power your day with purpose. Here is Ruchi Koval.
Did you ever wish that you could get a second chance? I mean, we all do things we regret, and we all have certain parts of our lives that we wish we could delete or at least edit. Is it possible? Sam Polk was a 30-year-old hedge fund trader on Wall Street, and in his last year on the job, his bonus, okay, was $3.6 million. But he was angry because he felt that it wasn't big enough. He had no children to raise, no debts to pay, no philanthropic goals. But as he puts it, he was addicted to wealth. Sam describes in his memoir, For the Love of Money, how he had traded in his alcoholism and drug abuse of his younger years for something that he calls wealth addiction. And it was actually his wealthy bosses who helped him see how limited his life was, because they had all profited from the 2008 financial crisis. And he was in a meeting once, he and some other traders, and they were talking about the new hedge fund regulations and how terrible they would be. And so Sam asked, but isn't it better for the system as a whole? And his boss said, I don't have the brain capacity to think about the system as a whole. All I'm concerned with is how this affects our company. It was that moment, Sam says, that he really got the second chance that he needed, because he was just thunderstruck by what he had become. And he couldn't live that life anymore. So he walked away from his millions of dollars and from that rush, that adrenaline, right, of making money that he had become so addicted to. But he couldn't run away from the fact anymore that he wasn't helping to fix any problems in the world, and he was kind of profiting from them. In the 3 years that he had left Wall Street, after he left Wall Street, Sam got married, spoke in jails and juvenile detention centers about getting sober, taught a writing class to girls in the foster system, and started not one but two nonprofits, which are called respectively Grocery Ships and Every Table, to help low-income families buy and eat healthy food. So Sam was really given a second chance at life, and he was given an opportunity to find meaning, right? But, I mean, walking away from all that wealth and all that adrenaline, that's not easy. And it's often a crisis or a fall from grace that makes us realize that we need a second chance so badly, and that really gives us the motivation or the kick in the pants to walk away and start over. In the Torah this week, we read the story of the formation of a mini holiday, almost unknown. It's called Pesach Sheni, or translated, the second Passover. So this mini holiday was brought about when a group of Jews in the desert approached Moses, and they were feeling sad and lost because they had been unable to celebrate Passover due to various circumstances beyond their control. But the point is that they had missed out, and they really wanted a second chance. So Moses confers with God, and boom, the second Passover was born. Moses literally created a new law, a new holiday, and a new commandment that's still commemorated today, exactly 1 month after Passover every year. Some families, including ours, even enjoy a little matzah on the second Passover to show the meaning of the day. This past year, in March 2020, Ellie Beer, who is an American living in Israel and the founder of the United Hatzalah Emergency Response Organization, he was in Florida fundraising for his incredible organization, but unfortunately he contracted COVID-19, and for an entire month, Ellie was in the hospital in Miami and his life was hanging in the balance, thousands of miles away from his family. He was intubated and unconscious throughout the entire holiday of Passover. Jews all over the world, including us, prayed for him, and finally he recovered, and he flew back to Israel on April 21st, 2020. 2 weeks later, on the second Passover, he was surrounded by his family in Israel, and he sat down to a beautiful Seder exactly 1 month after the holiday, and celebrated his opportunity, his second chance, with so much gratitude and love. When I saw the photo of Ellie and his family, which had gone viral, celebrating their second chance, both at Passover, but more broadly at being a family and at life itself. I mean, when I saw that, my eyes just filled with tears. What a blessing that they had this opportunity to make up for lost time and to get a redo. So many didn't. David Brooks is a journalist and author, and he writes in his book called The Second Mountain that many people find themselves confronted by this second chance at some point in their lives. And he describes in his book that there's this first mountain that people scale in their lives, and that would be finding a career path, establishing ourselves in society, finding a spouse, creating a family. But then they often look around and feel that somehow it's just not enough. Somehow the first mountain can feel self-centered. And then they often experience some crisis, some fall from grace, perhaps a divorce, an illness, a financial decline, and they start to wonder, like, how can I bring meaning into the world? The second mountain, says David Brooks, brings them from self-focused to other-focused. They want a life of interdependence, not independence. So the second mountain is kind of the mountain of meaning. It's the second chance to do better. What's so interesting about the story of the second Passover in the desert is that the law was not given to Moses along with all the other laws, but it was only the approach of these disappointed Jews in the desert that brought down the law, so to speak, from heaven to earth. So in a way, the Jews who missed out are the ones who lit the spark for this new holiday, which kind of shows you that sometimes when you really want something very badly, when you want or need the second chance, you have to put the idea out in the universe, and you have to make the first move, because you have to show that you're willing to walk away from wealth addiction or self-centered behavior in order to earn God's grace. God tells us in the Torah, "Open for me an opening the size of the eye of a needle, and I will open for you an opening as spacious as a banquet hall." What this means is that God wants us to make the first move, even if it's so tiny that nobody can see it but you and God. And it's that first move, those tentative steps towards something new and different, that will invite from God the blessing and the largesse that we need to succeed. So if the Jews are feeling disappointed at missing out in the desert, and that invited the creation of a whole new holiday of second chances, imagine what God can do for you if you open your heart and mind for your second chance. Imagine what the universe is waiting for from you. Are you ready?
This is the Book of Life. Don't forget to rate, review, and subscribe to Momentum Podcasts on Apple, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcast. Join Ruchi again next time for more meaning and inspiration from Judaism's most important book, to power your day with purpose.
You're listening to a Momentum podcast. For unlimited inspiration, wisdom, and empowerment, visit MomentumUnlimited.org.